to go to NASA to see a rocket launch. Woo! Invited by the awesome team at NASA Social to head down to Cape Canaveral, Florida to watch next Monday's launch of the SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket carrying NASA's TESS satellite into orbit. The NASA Social program, previously called NASA Tweetup, is an initiative by NASA to increase awareness in their scientific programs all over the country. This event will give me the same access as a traditional media journalist, and although I don't yet have a formal itinerary, these events usually include the opportunity to look behind the scenes at some of NASA's facilities, participate in media briefings, attend special facility tours, as well as the opportunity to speak with scientists, engineers, astronauts, and program managers about the work happening at NASA. For this event, I'll be flying down to Florida to watch SpaceX launch the Transiting Exoplanet Survey Satellite, or TESS for short. The TESS satellite will be launched onboard SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket and will be monitoring over 500,000 stars in our solar neighborhood in search of other planets. At liftoff, SpaceX will be aiming to place TESS into a highly elliptical orbit that is about 200 kilometers from the Earth at its closest approach and extends out over 250,000 kilometers at its apogee, which is about two-thirds of the way to the moon. At that point, the SpaceX portion of the mission will be complete, but TESS will have more adjustments to make before it reaches its final orbit. TESS will perform several adjustments to increase its apogee out even further, eventually performing a lunar flyby to get a gravity boost from the moon. That gravity boost will change the orbital inclination to tilt the orbit downward about 37 degrees and extend it out even further. One final adjustment is then made by TESS to set its orbital period to exactly 13.7 days or half of the moon's orbital period, which will keep this orbit stable for decades. Once in orbit, TESS will use its four onboard cameras to map both the northern and southern hemispheres in 13 sectors each, with a planned mission duration of 2 years. Now, that's just the initial mission timeline, and it certainly has the potential to be extended well after that initial mission. TESS will be monitoring the light received from distant stars to detect planets that pass in front of those stars. If and when a planet passes in front of one of those stars that it's monitoring, TESS will be able to detect the small drop in visual brightness to measure the planet's mass, size, and density. TESS is expected to identify around 3,000 exoplanets, with around 20 of them being considered Earth-like and potentially habitable. This mission is essentially a precursor for the upcoming James Webb Space Telescope. TESS will survey the sky to locate potential candidates for the JWST to look at, which is 100 times more powerful than the Hubble telescope. Every 13.7 days, TESS will downlink the data it has collected back to Earth. So that's the mission, and I'm super excited. If it launches on time, this will be the first rocket launch that I'll get to witness in person. Well, there it is. I can't wait for this trip. Let me know what questions you have about the mission, and I'll be sure to get to them. Since this NASA social event is centered all around social media, I'll be posting lots of updates on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. So be sure you're following me on all three platforms so you don't miss anything. I'm intending to live broadcast at least once every day while I'm there, including a live broadcast for the actual launch itself, assuming I can get adequate mobile bandwidth to do so. I hope you'll join me for those Saturday, Sunday, and Monday. This should be awesome. Thanks for checking out this video. If you liked it and you like what we do, hit that thumbs up button. If you want to learn more about my upcoming trip, check out the links in the description below. Thanks again for watching. I'll see you in a couple days live from Florida.